so we're near the end of your basic Pilates mat session, possibly the first you've ever done. And I would imagine if you've been listening to all my teaching points, you're probably doing really well. The reason why I'm still in this position is because the move before meant that we finished here, and I like the exercises to flow from one to the other, or you can do them standalone. So from this position, you would come onto the side and then simply onto all fours for the next move, which is called the Superman. You can do that, but I'm just going to turn myself around so I'm here, so I can see you a little bit better, and you probably get a better angle on my body positioning too. So the Superman is working everything, and it's really challenging your alignment. And at this stage in the game, in the class, it's really going to challenge your focus and alignment. And this is really important. It's a complete full body move. And it goes like this. Arms are greater than shoulder width apart, with those elbows switched off lock. And again, that means we're not activating the big muscles in the upper part of the arms at all. We're focusing on the stabilizers through the shoulder girdle. Pull your scapulas, your dinner plates, back and down your spine, under your bra strap towards your bottom. Inhale as you exhale. Keep your spine in neutral. Again, it helps if you can look in the mirror to the side of you to see if you're hyperextended or indeed if you're humping at all. Really avoid that, it's one of my pet bugbears. Knees directly beneath each hip. Inhale as you exhale. Set your breathing. Lift your core and hold it there. Remain breathing over the top. For the Superman, rather like the dart, you can just use the upper body and exhale. In isolation, exhale as you float the arm, thumb to the ceiling and down, or you can just use the lower body in isolation as you're building the strength and precision of movement for this move, the Superman. But of course, it wouldn't be called the Superman if you weren't to do it opposite arm to opposite leg when you're ready and feel comfortable. Inhale, exhale, reach one arm and the opposing leg away from you, lengthening the limb away from you without displacing through the shoulder or the hips. Try to keep your spine as still as possible. Inhale as you exhale, float it back down. Inhale as you exhale, move to the other side, keeping the foot switched off across the floor on the supporting leg. Keeping your spine neutral and those elbows soft on the supporting arm, neck in neutral too. Inhale as you exhale, another great visual cue or an internally proprioceptive rather thing for you to think about is imagine a tray on your back, and in the corner of each tray as it sits, shoulder blade, back of your hip, back of your hip, is a glass of water, or if you want to be more extravagant, a glass of something sparkly and expensive. I can't help myself, sorry. And you don't want to lose a single drop from a single glass. And again, it's when looking in the mirror, you'd be able to see just how still you're keeping that tray as it sits across your back. Or you can get a friend to monitor it for you. Not the glasses of sparkling champagne, but the glasses of water and your spine activated, still, and aligned and strong. That's your Superman. Well done.